Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. I'm hoping you guys are all having a fantastic day. So, before we get this video started, I would like to quickly announce like one thing. You know, that this is not a copy of, or you know, just like showing the Farmer's Almanac. This is kind of like my own twist. I will be showing you what the Farmer's Almanac is showing, what they're forecasting and calling, and I'll compare it to mine, and we'll see, you know, what the similarities are, what the differences are, and why I think this winter will be fairly cold. That's what the Farmer Almanac is calling for as well, just, you know, a little bit foreshadowing. Also, I do have a Patreon in the description box below. It's going to be in the description. It's going to say Patreon. You could click on a link, and it basically means you could donate $1 or $2 if you are willing to support this channel. And it goes monthly, but you could leave it after any month. And for those that are the Patreons right now, I have not been active, and I do apologize, but, if we get $200, I will be, I will be there every, I'll be uploading every day, and, you know, I would just still really mean a lot if you could just support it. So thank you for doing that. So, right now, again, Farmer's Winter Almanac forecast. Let's jump into this. Consider subscribing, consider liking this video, consider dropping a nice comment in the comment box below. I always love seeing your comments. So, right now, if you're watching this, you could comment, where you're watching from, or just a nice comment. Always helps out. Thank you for doing so. So this is the Farmer's Almanac, the new Farmer Almanac, not the old one. And that's something that some people get confused. The Farmer's Almanac since 1818, but the old Farmer's Almanac is even older. I think it's from the 1790s, something like that, 700s. And they're the two competing companies, but I have both of their winter outlooks that they release, and you can see right there it says 2019-2020 winter outlook, polar coaster winter ahead. That's what their headline is, and you could see, I mean, find your location. If you go to the Northeast, includes lots of states, including Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and New York, Massachusetts, Connecticut, Rhode Island, Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. It says cold, wintry mix. So possibly a nor'easter that, you know, could bring some rain if it's a bigger one or stronger. If it's closer to the shore, it could be lots of snow. And then if we get to the mid-Atlantic, you could see right in here states like Virginia, West Virginia, Kentucky, North Carolina. It says frosty, wet, and white. So, you know, it kind of a combination of all of these three. Could be pretty chilly at times. Could get, you know, frosty cold. Could get wet, you know, if it's a little bit warmer, a little warmer phase during the winter, could get wet. And also could get white if, you know, if it's cold enough and there's precip, there could be a big snowstorm. The southeast, you can see it says brisk and wet. The brisk kind of implies that they're thinking it will be cooler across those locations. And I do as well think that the southeast will be cooler. And sometimes, you know, if some cooler conditions are overlying with some wet conditions, we might even see, you know, some snow falling in some locations. So that's always, you know, something interesting to see snow in the south, especially the southeast. And it has happened in the years past, like northern Georgia, northern Alabama. We will see about that this year. I do think that there's an elevated chance of that happening. You can see the Midwest, frozen, comma, snowy. So basically that's what it means, you know, just very cold, chilly temperatures, several outbreaks of really cold air, Arctic air, and and snowy as well, filled with snow. But they think, or they say, that the coldest part of the winter, the kind of like the brunt of the cold air, will be right across the upper plains, the east, western Midwest, kind of Iowa, Minnesota, Kansas, Nebraska, Missouri. You can see it says frigid and snowy. So snowy as well, big snowstorms, but frigid. So that is, that's probably, you know, like the biggest word you could use for snow. Versus, you know, see in northeast it says cold, but here it says frigid. So I do think as well it will be cold. I'm just not sure, you know, if like the most western portions of Montana will be seeing the frigid conditions. I think they may be more, you know, chillier or even warmer. I think that the only area I disagree with the Farmer Almanac, the new Farmer Almanac, is the west. I think now, based on some new predictions and new forecasts that came in, new model runs, I think that the west will be rather warm, on the warmer side, and they say chilly and cool, and I don't agree with that. Normal precipitation, we'll see about that. It may be a little bit above, but right now they're calling for chilly and cool. I think it's going to be warmer, especially for the southwest. Northwest, I'll give it a little bit bigger percentage of maybe, 30% chance of it being a little bit warmer. But that's basically what it looks like for the Farmer's Almanac 2019-2020 winter outlook. And if we were to go to the old, notice how it says old Farmer's Almanac, it's different, completely different. Of weather map for winter 2019-2020, you could see it looks a little bit different, a little bit less nice. It looks complicated at first, but then you start, noticing what they tried doing, and it's basically just outlining in different colors. So find your location and find it. You can see they have for the Northeast wet and wild. So see, that's why I don't like this one that much, because, you don't really know what wild really infers or implies to. It could, if you really wanted to, it could mean very warm conditions, wet, especially since they're saying wet, so that may not imply cold, but I'm assuming it does, like the wild part. And then they also are showing wintry for the Ohio Valley, kind of West Virginia area, Virginia, and down into the Appalachian Mountains. Wintry, mild with soakers, so probably some big rain systems for the Southeast. They just put nice for Florida, pleasant for Texas and Oklahoma, snow, ice, icky for the Midwest right here. More wet than white for these locations. I agree less with this one and more with this one. It feels like they didn't put any thought into this. You could see it says for the west, it says wet or worse, the very coastal wet. I think that might be true, maybe very wet. And then all it says dry and chilly though for California. Low temperatures, deep powder. I'm not sure about that for the west. I think it will actually be, I think it will actually be less powder this year and higher temperatures, but it's the old Farmer's Almanac. They've been doing this for many years. And here's the thing. Here's how the almanacs do it. So they obviously incorporate some of the newer stuff, like, the neutral, the end zone, all that. But they also do things like what the squirrels are acting like, what the insects are showing, what the leaves are, when they change. They do some of that more old-fashioned style, which is good to a certain extent because, they've been using it for many centuries, and some people swear by those methods and say that's the only way to predict winter. I wouldn't say so, but definitely they have, like, the Farmer's Almanac, at least the new one. I don't recall what the old one said, but the new one said that it would be frigid and frozen and cold and snowy across the Midwest and East, basically, and that's what happened. And it was supposed to be warmer across the West, and that's kind of what happened. So, that's very, some people don't like the Farmer's Almanac. I kind of like them. I like them because they give you a good idea of what's to come. Sometimes they're off, but sometimes they're not. And then here you can see the 2019-20 and 2020 my winter outlook, my winter forecast. And you can see I put average could change, however, for the West. I would probably change this now to warmer, possibly. Maybe not hot, but a tad warmer. I wouldn't change it too hot, but yeah, just a little bit warmer, definitely not cold. And in the Northwest, I put cold, plus snowy if La Nina develops or has a bigger chance of developing. Right now, it seems like it doesn't, and I would eliminate it and probably put average or maybe a little bit warmer / milder. That's probably the best term to put. And I think it will be wet and maybe snowy for the mountains, and most likely snowy for the mountains, because even if it's not cold, the mountains are usually still cold enough. below 32 degrees where their average is, pretty chilly. So even if it's above average, you could still see snow when it's raining anywhere else in the West. And notice how I put brutal cold attacks and lake effect snow. Notice how I had it more centered to the East rather than the West. They had it centered more to the West, the new Farmer's Almanac. That's the one disagreement. I put blizzards and cold. I forgot what they put. They put cold wintry mix. So yeah, that seems about right. They both put cold. We both agree it'll be pretty wild. And then some big snows possible. I would still put this in here because if some of those cold, attacks of air make it way to the south and we have a storm that develops along the front, we could see some big snows for the south, maybe, 5-6 inches, which may not seem like a lot for those that live in the north, but for the southern locations, that is plenty. And then Florida and the coastal southeast, it says wet plus some snow. The some snow really is kind of an over-exaggeration, but mainly just wet and possibly warmer or cooler, depending on when the fronts come through. But you could see we had, some definite similarities between our forecasts.
And now I'd like to also show you the Enzo neutral winter. This is, I think, what they... Sorry about the blurry picture, by the way. But this is probably one of the things they were looking at, the almanacs. And this is one of my forecasts, as, or one of my forecasting pieces as well. I think, you know, that, I mean, we know that this year is going to be a neutral pattern for at least the fall and early winter. And you can see that it shows a cold air across the east and the north. And that's why I think it might, you know, that's why I centered mine a little bit further to the east, the cold air. Because that's what this one shows, and I also put blizzards for the northeast because of this wet and warm overriding each other that could produce some snow, and then again the Pacific jet stream just riding into the northwest, so that may, you know, produce some warm but some wet conditions at the same time. And then I think this is my final piece that I have included. It's just my fall forecast, and you could see I put average for a good chunk of the country. Now I would probably increase the warmer to a little bit, you know, towards the east into the mountains, Rockies, Colorado, Wyoming, Idaho, and then northwest I'll still put just milder, maybe not warmer, just a little tad milder. You can see I also had that same scenario going through, that cold shots through fall are possible, and some wild weather towards the northeast as well. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that gave you a better insight on, you know, what the Farmer's Almanac is showing. And thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in the next episode. See ya. Bye.